Hello students, I am here discussing some previous year problems on the quadratic equation which are asked in IIT mains. So here is a problem in IIT mains 2013. The number of values of k for which the system of equation, this equation, has no solution. The first option is 3, other option is infinite, third option is 1 and fourth one is 2. So we have to solve this equation for no solution. For no solution, the condition is a1 upon a2 equal to b1 upon b2 is not equal to c1 upon c2. So here is three cases made. First one is k1 plus upon k is equal to 8 upon k plus 3 not equal to 4k upon 3k minus 1. First case is this, other case is this, and third one case is this one. So we have to solve all three cases. The case one is this way, this solve. So just cross multiply it and solve it, and we get k equal to 1 and k equal to 3. The other case, second one, is this not equal to this. So just cross multiply it and solve it, and we get k not equal to 5 and k not equal to 1. The final third case, just cross multiply it and we get k not to 1. So the given condition is satisfied in all the three cases. So we have to take the intersection of all the cases. So we have take intersection of all the case k0 to 5, k0 to 1, k0 to 1, and here we find that k equal to 1 and k equal to 3. So the final solution is k0 to 1, so k is only 3. So not is the answer is 3, because he asked the number of values, so the number of values is only 1. So answer is 1 solution. Here is a question in the IIT mains 2014. Let alpha and beta are the roots of the equation. In this equation, px square plus qx plus r equal to 0, where p not equal to 0. This condition is given because it is a coefficient of x square. If p is equal to 0, the equation becomes linear. So there is no quadratic equation and there is no root of two roots. If p, q, r is r and ap, these are conditions which are given in the questions. Given in and 1 upon alpha plus 1 upon beta equal to 4, then the value of alpha minus beta, it's a modulus. So it's modulus of alpha minus beta. So we have to solve. So given is px square plus qx plus r equal to 0, then two roots alpha and beta, then sum of roots alpha plus beta equal to minus q by p, and product of roots are alpha r by p, which is alpha and alpha cross beta. The other given condition is 1 upon alpha plus 1 upon beta equal to 4. Then we take LCMs and solve alpha plus beta upon alpha beta equal to 4. Then put this first equation into this, and we get minus q by p up on r by p. And finally we get q equal to minus 4r. This was our second equation. We know alpha minus beta ka modulus equal to under root of alpha plus beta ka whole square minus 4 alpha beta. Then take under root and solve it. Then put the equation, put the values alpha plus beta. What is that? Minus q by p, and 4 alpha beta is r by p. Then put that here. Now we finally get this equation. Let's say this is our third equation. We have given condition that alpha beta are the roots of this equation. So we put p alpha square plus q alpha plus r equal to 0 and p beta square plus q beta plus r equal to 0, and we just subtract these two equations. Then we get p into alpha square minus beta square plus q into alpha minus beta equal to 0, and here we take a common alpha minus beta, and finally we get p alpha plus beta plus q equal to 0. So the alpha plus beta is minus q by p. So this equation is 0. Here we get alpha not equal to beta. Now we have another conditions. P comma q comma r is in AP. It means that p q r in AP. So the from AP we say that 2q is equal to p plus r. This is the fourth equation. From previous equation, put fourth equation in the second equation, where 2 into minus 4r equal to p plus r. So minus 8r is equal to p plus r. So p equal to minus 9r. This is our fifth equation. Put fifth equation in the third equation we get in this under root, and put there p equal to minus 9r. And finally we get in the only in value of r. And finally we notice that r square is cancelled from numerator and also in denominator. Like this, and we finally get 2 root 13 by 9. There are also a question in IIT mains 2015. The question is, let alpha and beta be the roots of this equation x square minus 6x minus 2 equal to 0. If This is a notation of a n equal to be alpha ki power n minus beta ki power n for n greater than equal to be 1. Then he asks the values of a 10 minus 2 times a 8 divided by 2 a 9 is equal to. There are 4 options. One is minus 3, other one is 6, third one is minus 6, and fourth one is 3. So the given equations, just such a quadratic equation, x square minus 6x minus 2 equal to 0 and 2 roots alpha and beta. So let's put alpha and beta in this equation because they are the roots of this. So alpha and beta satisfy well this equation, is this quadratic equation. So alpha square minus 6 alpha minus 2 equal to be 0. This says alpha square minus 2 equal to be 6 alpha and beta square minus 6 beta minus 2 equal to be 0. This gives beta square minus 2 equal to 6 beta. Let's say this is our first equation. The denotation notation a 10, what does mean? It is alpha ki power 10 minus beta ki power 10. A 9 is alpha ki power 9 minus beta ki power 9, and a 8 alpha ki power 8 minus beta ki power 8. Now put these in this question which is asked. So we get alpha ki power 10 minus beta ki power 10 minus 2 times alpha ki power 8 minus beta ki power 8 divided by 2 alpha ki power 9 minus beta ki power 9. So we here take alpha ki power 8 common. Just take alpha ki power 10 minus 2 alpha ki power 8 simultaneously, and other one is beta ki power 10 minus beta ki power 8. Now here we can common alpha ki power 8, and here we take alpha ki beta ki power 8. And finally here we get alpha square minus 2 and beta square minus 2. And from the first equation we get alpha square minus 2 equal to 6 beta. So here put these values alpha ki power 8 into 6 alpha minus beta ki power 8 6 beta. Here 6 is finally common, and alpha ki power 9 minus beta ki power 9 remain. So it was cancelled from numerator and denominator, and finally we get 6 by 2 which is 3. So there are continuous questions asked into 2013, 14 and 15, and it is an important topic for quadratic equation. And if your doubts are clear, then like, subscribe my channel, and thanks for it.